So, still winter here, but we have a nice day. So I thought I would go meet these guys at Cycle Gear. I'm probably gonna miss them, so I'll be riding by myself, but oh well. I just hope I don't get pulled over for only having one mirror. So I still haven't fixed my throttle. It's still held on by a hose clamp and a piece of rope, I guess, for lack of a better term. I'm gonna be going slow as fuck through intersections because people like that pull out right in front of you. Not gonna be doing any stupid shit because my tires are cold and it's cold out. I really don't want to go down. Turns out I have a couple torn ligaments along with my broken bones. So I got the broken clavicle, which there's about an inch and a half broke out of the clavicle, like a piece completely broke out of the middle. Hold on here, let me get this shit. There we go. So yeah, an inch and a half broke out of the middle, and both of the ends are frayed. Both of the ends where the bone is broke off are, I guess you'd call it fractured. They're splintered all over the place, so. And then it turns out I have three ribs in the front that were separated from the sternum. Well, it sounds a little windy today. I'm not sure why. Hope you can hear me. One rib cracked in the back. Then I have two torn ligaments. One of them's over a 50% tear, and the other one's a smaller tear. It's about a centimeter. And I actually think I have more bone than that. The right side of my arm, below my shoulder and above my elbow, is completely numb. When I feel my skin, it feels like not my skin. It feels like a Band-Aid or something like that. My shoulder blade, my shoulder, my arm all have like no heat sensation. My wife was massaging me with a heated massager, and I'm like, hon, I don't think that massager works. She had just bought it for me for Christmas or something, I don't recall, but and she put it on the middle of my back and it fucking burned the shit out of me. So it wasn't the massager, it was my back or my shoulder, shoulder blade, etc. Also the right side of my head, all around my ear, from about, I don't know, an inch or two above my ear, an inch or two all around it, feels like you went to the dentist, got Novocaine, and when the Novocaine starts to wear off, you get that tingly, kind of painful, you know, but not like, it's not like it hurts real bad or anything, it's just annoyingly slightly painful. Anyways, the whole, my ear and the whole right side of my head is like that ever since the accident. So, I don't know, man, I got pretty fucked up in that accident. I think there's, what I was saying was, I think there's more wrong. I think I've actually ripped some of my shoulder blade muscles towards the center of my back by the spine. And I'm pretty sure I've damaged a couple nerves. Possibly one in my armpit area that controls the outer arm, and then possibly one in my head somewhere, which controls my brain function. No, I'm just kidding. So anyways, yeah, guess chalk me up as loving to ride or stupid, one of the two, because like I said, I haven't fixed my throttle. I'm kind of afraid to get in there. I will, but my arm still hurts daily, and I don't know, you know, what I'm really afraid of is getting it apart and not getting it back together and not being able to ride when you get these freak chances of good sunshine. And I can't say it's warm. I have my thermal gear on and it's still freaking chilly. So, but I just can't help it. I can't help myself. All I can say is I hope everything goes well. And hopefully I haven't missed everybody from Cycle Gear. And I'm gonna ride two-handed because my fucking right arm still hurts. So yeah, I haven't motovlogged in quite a while, but hopefully to everybody it's understandable. Not only the wreck, but where I live, there is months of snow on the ground, snow on these highways. Just these last 3 days, everything's been melting and warming up, so it's cool. I just wish I already had my surgery. I'm really tentative about getting the surgery. I've looked up some videos. There's something called Trigenics, where they do absolutely no surgery. By the way, I have frozen shoulder too, so there's something called Trigenics where there requires absolutely no surgery, and within a couple minutes they fix your frozen shoulder. You can go from only being able to lift your arm, you know, just a few inches, to being able to put your arm all the way up above your head, which would be amazing. If I'll just have the surgery, if I'll just try to work it out through therapy, which usually is a very low success rate, just having therapy. I can't remember, but it's like 5% or less that can be fixed with therapy. If I have the surgery, I run the risk of not being able to move my arm again for 6 weeks, or being in a sling anyways. I don't like being by this truck. Being in a sling for 6 weeks, which, you know, and running the risk of something happening in surgery, and you know, not being able to move your arm again and getting frozen shoulder again. So I don't know, that looks like a cop right there, if I'll do that or not. I just don't know, we'll see. We'll see what happens. Oh my God, he was radaring too. I hope to ever loving Jesus that he didn't get, I was just doing 70 right there too. I wanted to get away from that semi, but he could surely fucking get me. I was being stupid. Anyhow, yeah, we'll see. I don't know. Sometimes I think, well, I can ride, so I'll just live with it. But really, there's just no quality of life there. I can barely use two hands to put anything above my head. You know, like having to lift something on a shelf the other day, it's killer. Anyways, that's where I'm at. We'll just see. You know, I have no idea how well things are gonna go, but I will keep you updated. Almost to Cycle Gear. Hopefully there's still people here. I don't even know what gear I'm in. It's been a long time since I rode. Boy, I think I see a couple bikes there. I'm gonna take it fucking easy. Especially around corners and shit. I know my tires are not great. and it's really hard to lean appropriately with my shoulder the way it is. So well, looks like that cop's not pulling me over, which is awesome sauce. And looks like the people are still here, which is cool. Fuck, shoulder still hurts daily. It's a bummer. Oh, that's me. That's my cue. How you doing?
Hello, my brother. How you feeling?
I'm still hurting every day.
Yeah?
I still got ab surgery, so.
Okay. You have
ab surgery? Yeah, I got two torn ligaments. One of them's over 50% torn, and the other one's about a centimeter torn. And I have frozen. What's that?
Have you done the surgery?
No.
Do they have to re-break?
You know what's? No. They're not. They could, but they're not gonna. What sucks is I went through how many months of therapy, and I'm like telling the therapy guy, man, that really hurts, and I'm not a wussy. And they didn't, none of the doctors or therapists recommended. I had to ask to go get an MRI, and that's when they found the two torn ligaments, frozen shoulder. I mean, all right. Everybody else's bike's all nice and ready to go. Mine's all tore up still. Kind of sucks. You know, I promised when I made my channel that I'd show you guys some me practicing wheelies, but that might be quite a ways in the future, if ever. I love riding. I'm gonna just say that after the bad break that I had and everything, I think that I love riding more than the fact that I would love trying to do something that could cause more downtime and not being able to ride. But I'll still motovlog, still try to get you guys some good scenery, some good rides, maybe other people doing crazy shit. Not so much myself. So also, I want to thank all my subscribers. I think I have 111 now, and I know that I promised a giveaway at 100 subscribers, and I haven't got around to it. I hope you understand why. I've been very busy with pain and laying in bed for a long time, but I will get to it, and soon, as soon as I can. Not sure what's a good idea to a good item to give away. I have this Texaco bank. I know it's not much. I would like to get some stickers made up for like maybe a second and third, you know, the grand prize will be, you know, a Texaco bank or something. But yeah, I just don't really have much else. I'll get some stickers made up for second and third. I will do a drawing. I guess I'll do a video before that, and we'll have everybody that posts in the video, I'll enter their name into the drawing. Are you going? Are you going? Yeah? Cool. good group of guys here. I'll tell you what, when I had my accident, I just put a post on Facebook because I really couldn't think of anything else to do. I said, need help, Sprague and Havana. And boy, within 5 minutes, there was like six, seven guys showed up, a truck to take my bike to my house. A week after my accident, I don't know, 15, 20 guys showed up to my house to see how I was doing. That is the great part about a riding group. That you got, you know, a bunch of nice people that have as friends and do stuff with if you want. But man, it's so nice for them to come and help me. So, awesome group of guys. You guys, if you live in Spokane or Idaho, or in the vicinity, and ride and don't ride in a group, it's a really good group. We have arrived at Sweeto Burrito. All right, I have to ride out for a little bit again.